Hello, I'm Graham and I hope everyone's having a great day and welcome to today's video. Now in this video I'm going to have a look at the program mode operation of Panasonic Lumix cameras, and in particular I want to look at what's called the program shift operation. Now that will apply to all the bridge camera range, so the 200, the 300,000, the 2500 that I'm shooting this video with, and it will apply to the G series cameras. Now, although there's a P mode in the travel zooms, there isn't a program shift operation, so unfortunately the shift operation won't work with that range. But we're going to concentrate on the bridge camera range today, and in particular the FZ200 and the FZ300, to give you an idea of what the program mode's all about and why we'd use the program shift operation. Well, first of all, why would you be shooting in the P mode anyway? Well, the clue may be in the fact, if you look at the mode control dial, you'll see that the P mode is just one step away from the intelligent auto mode. Now, we know in the intelligent auto mode, the camera uses sophisticated algorithms to try and determine what sort of scene you're capturing. So we'll look at the colour components of your image, it'll look at the density between the subject and the background, and try and figure out whether you're using it for a landscape mode, a portrait, whether you're in close-up, shooting food, those sort of things, and it will try and determine the best exposure under those situations. Now, it's only an algorithm, and sometimes it gets that wrong. So you could be shooting a portrait, for example, and it selects a landscape mode. So you're going to end up with exaggerated greens and blues in that scene. So that's one of the instances where you'd switch out of the intelligent auto mode and select one of the correct scene modes. But the P mode allows you to take photographs under unusual lighting circumstances, and it allows you to set your own white balance. It takes away all the intelligent features such as intelligent resolution, intelligent dynamic range, all those sort of intelligent operations which sometimes can actually affect the image quality to an adverse degree rather than enhance it. So in P mode, the camera examines the light coming in through the camera lens towards the sensor, and then it will give you the best exposure based on some software algorithms that the program designers have given to work out the best aperture, the best shutter speed, and the best ISO under those conditions. Now you have some control over the way that the camera will do that. In the FZ200, you've got a little bit more control than you have on the later cameras, as the FZ200 allows you to set what's called the minimum shutter speed. With the other cameras, you could end up with a shutter speed that's below the handheld limit. But with the FZ200, you can set the minimum shutter speed so that you don't go into those situations. When we go through the actual setup of the P mode and the program shift, I'll show you that in both the FZ200 and the 300 to give you an idea of what we're talking about in that instance. So let's set up a scene and let's have a look at the P mode, what it gives you in terms of aperture and shutter, and what the shift operation gives you so you can change the operating conditions of the camera. Well, I've set up the FZ200 on a tripod to shoot this tabletop scene. I've set up in the IA plus mode, as that gives you a few more control features over the standard IA mode. You'll notice that if I try and take this picture straight away, I press the shutter button, it's given me an aperture of f2.8. It's got intelligent ISO set, and it's focused on the two areas that it thinks are the principal areas of focus for this shot. Let's first of all take our first exposure in the IA plus mode to give us a base or benchmark. And if I press the shutter halfway down, we'll see the exposure is f2.8. The camera has set up intelligent ISO, so it will determine the best ISO for this particular scene. If I take that shot, we'll see that it's a 60th of a second at ISO 400. Now we know the camera performs best at ISO 100, so it would be better if we took this shot at ISO 100, and that would give us a better image quality. To do that, we would need to change to either the aperture priority mode or the shutter priority mode or the program mode so that we've got control of the ISO, as in the IA mode, we've got no facilities for changing ISO. We'll now switch over to the P mode so we can see this in operation. Turn the top control dial to the P position, and you can see that emulated on the LCD screen. I've got ISO set to 100, so that gives me the best image quality with the lowest noise. If I just press the shutter button halfway down, you'll see that the exposure calculated by the camera is going to be 1/25th of a second at f2.8 with the ISO of 100. So I'll just take that first shot as a benchmark. But I'll know I'll need much more depth of field to encompass the foreground to background distance in this particular shot. So how do I achieve more depth of field? obviously I changed the aperture to a smaller aperture. So at the moment we're at f2.8, and I think I'll be needing something like f5.6 or f6.3 to give me enough depth of field in this particular shot. So how do I do that when the camera is telling me it's going to be f2.8? Well, I use what's called the program shift operation, and in the FZ200 that's engaged by using the back control dial. And if I turn that to the right when the camera is displaying the aperture and shutter speed combination, it puts me into the program shift mode. And you can now see that we brought up the diagonal arrows and we've now got an aperture of f3.2. Continue turning to the right and you can see that I'm going up to f4, 4.5, 5, 5.6, 6.3. So I'm going to take this at f6.3. It's giving me a shutter speed of 1/5 of a second. As we're on a tripod, that's okay. So I'm going to take that shot. And now we've got more depth of field on the image, as we can see in the video. Now, you might ask, how do I achieve exposure compensation? If the camera is metering this, but it's metering it wrong because of the subject to background contrast difference, how would I change the exposure to make that correct? Well, you still have control of the exposure value compensation control on the FZ200. That's achieved by pressing in the back control dial. You can now see that the scale has changed from the camera EV indicator to a plus and minus scale, which is the exposure value compensation. So if I felt this image was too bright, then I could make this darker by going to the minus EV stage. So I've gone down by a third of an EV. So that has darkened the scene. So we'll take that as a benchmark again. Notice that it's changed the shutter speed to 1/6 of a second, which is faster, which will give us that slight underexposure. So that's how we would engage the P mode, how we could actually change the aperture to what we want. And if we wanted to apply exposure value compensation, we can still do that in the P mode. Now, that program shift stays in operation all the time now that we're in that particular mode. It will always choose that aperture that we set, so 6.3. So if the lighting changes, then we will see a change in the shutter speed, as we've predetermined that we want to use ISO 100. Even if I go to, say, the intelligent auto mode for a particular shot, and I go back to the P mode, we'll notice that the P mode still remains set at f6.3. So it remembers that P mode until you actually turn off the camera. If you want to disable the P mode again, then whilst those two shutter speed and apertures are being displayed on the screen, use your back control dial and turn that until you see f2.8, and then it will turn off the program shift operation. Now with the FZ200, we do have the opportunity to set a minimum shutter speed, which is something we don't have on the later series cameras. So if I wanted to set a minimum shutter speed, so for example, if I'm using the camera outside and I want to use the camera above a 1/30 of a second, then I can set a minimum shutter speed. So if I go into the menu and we cursor down in the record setup menu to minimum shutter speed, you notice I can go from auto all the way down to the longest the camera will support, which is 1 second. So I'm going to set that to 1/30 of a second. So with my minimum shutter speed set to 1/30 of a second, if I try and take a scene which will result in a shutter speed less than a 1/30, it will give me a warning on the LCD screen. So for example, if I want to try and take this picture at f8 for maximum depth of field, if I go up to f8, we'll notice that if I try and press the shutter button, I get a warning on the LCD screen, and it's flashing in red to say that the shutter speed of minimum value 1/30 has been exceeded. So I need to change the aperture or the ISO so that the camera comes back into a normal exposure range. And you can see with the exposure scale that for 1/30 of a second, anything between f8 and f5.6 would be unacceptable. So I would need to be below f5.6 to give me control of the exposure. So I need to go to f4 to take me outside the red band that the cameras determine will not be acceptable. So that's the FZ200. Let's have a look at that operation now on the FZ300. So now you can see I've got the FZ300 set up on the tripod, taking exactly the same situation. Notice the camera's determined this is a close-up and it's come up with the eye with the flower icon to determine that's a close-up scene. I have to press the shutter button. You can see that it's given me a 80th of a second at f2.8, again using the iISO, which is hardwired into the IA mode. So if I take that shot for the reference, I'll now switch over to the P mode on the top of the camera. Rotate the dial to the P position. You notice that's emulated on the screen with the P at the top left-hand side of your screen. We don't get that graphical user interface that we get with the FZ200 of the rotating screen, but at least we know we're in the P mode. Now, if I have to press the shutter button, the camera will tell me the exposure under these conditions. So it's 1/80th of a second, f2.8, with an ISO of 320. And again, in this P mode, I've got auto ISO set. So I know that I want ISO 100 to give me the best image quality, and I want an aperture of something like f5.6, f6.3 to give me the right depth of field. So first of all, I'm going to change the ISO to 100. So by depressing the ISO button and then cursoring through to give me ISO 100, menu set to lock that into the camera and come back into the shooting screen. Right, now I want to set an aperture of f5.6, but first of all I'll take that shot as a benchmark at ISO 100. Now while the aperture and shutter speed are displayed, I'll use the top control dial here now and I'll turn that to the left to bring in the program shift operation. So notice I've got 3.2, 3.5, I'm going to go all the way up to f5.6. At that particular aperture, the shutter speed is 1/6th of a second, as you can see on the screen. So when I take this picture, we'll take that exposure at that particular setting. Now, as with the FZ200, if I felt that the exposure circuit wasn't giving me the correct exposure due to the difference in contrast between the subject and background, I can use the exposure value compensation facility to correct for that. With the FZ300, you use the FN1 button to apply exposure value compensation. So pressing the FN1 button brings up the exposure value compensation. Now, as with the FZ200, if I felt this was a bit too light, I can darken it by going to the minus EV side. So again, using this top control dial, I can rotate it to the left and go down minus 1/3 EV. Now I can take that picture, and you notice the shutter speed has gone to 1/8th of a second to make the exposure shorter to darken it. So that is with minus 1/3 of an EV. With the FZ200, we had the facility to set a minimum shutter speed, but with the FZ300 and above, you don't have that facility, so you just have to look at the shutter speed. And if you were hand-holding this, you'd see that the shutter speed was too long. You would end up with a lot of camera shake. So in that situation, if you wanted to use that aperture of f5.6, you would have to use the ISO control to change the shutter speed to something that's more realistic. So if I went to ISO 800, which is 3 stops more than we had with ISO 100, if we look at the shutter speed now, we're up to 1/40th of a second. So we're now probably within handhold capability. And again, with the FZ300, as with the FZ200, program shift remains in operation even if you change to any of the other mode positions. When you go back to the P mode, you'll still see that you've got the value that you've locked in there, and it will stay there until you turn off the camera. Now, the algorithm used to set up the parameters for exposure in P mode are quite sophisticated, but the designers have tried to keep the aperture to f2.8 to f4 so you don't enter into what's called diffraction limited resolution. If you go into f5.6 and beyond, the camera starts to lose resolution because of the way that the light has to bend around the aperture blades. So the designers have got the algorithm right in trying to keep the apertures quite low. It's up to you to determine whether your shutter speed and your ISO are correct for the scene that you're taking. So if you wanted low noise and you've got the situation on a tripod, then you can use a lower ISO. If you're hand holding, then obviously you need to raise the ISO to enable the shutter speed to become shorter to enable you to take pictures without subject motion or handshake. Well, that's it for this short video. I hope you found that demonstration useful, and it's explained some of the mysteries around the program mode and the program shift operation, and it will allow you to go out and take better pictures. Do check out my photographic blog. I'll put a link to that in the video description below. You'll find lots more information on the bridge camera range and some of the compact systems cameras from Panasonic as well. Thanks very much for watching. Please do take care, and I'll see you all in the next one. Goodbye for now.